This is Dr. Cathleen Hanlon. I would like to extend a warm welcome from Kansas State University, the College of Veterinary Medicine, Veterinary Diagnostic Laboratory, and the K-State Rabies Laboratory to Dr. Gene McNeil from the New Hanover County Animal Control Services, and Dr. Robert Weedon, Senior Partner of College Road Animal Hospital and an Adjunct Professor at the University of North Carolina, Wilmington. And now Drs. McNeil and Weedon will tell us about their experience with Johnny the puppy.
Thank you so much for having us. It's a pleasure for us to be here today and to be able to share the story about Johnny. He came into our shelter at New Hanover County as a stray. A good Samaritan brought him in, and he had an open fracture of his radius and ulna, and we knew that we couldn't take care of him. It's especially good for us to speak to the veterinary community because we don't have the ability to care for these animals at our facility, so we have to carry them out to someone else who can do the treatment on them, and that's exactly what we did.
They transported Johnny to our practice, College Road Animal Hospital in Wilmington, North Carolina, and he was very cute. We thought that we could rehabilitate him and perhaps adopt him out. He did have an open fracture of his right radius and ulna, so we thought that we might splint his leg to allow the fracture to heal because he was a young puppy, about 12 weeks of age, 10 to 12 weeks of age or so, and let the open wound heal by changing the splint frequently. And we have radiographs of his fracture beforehand and after splinting. So, I mean, look how cute he is. How can you not want to adopt him out? We changed his splint every 3 days. His wound was healing very nicely. People heard about him. They came to see him. Many wanted to adopt him. And, you know, we were just really excited because he was so friendly. But after being in the hospital for 2 weeks, he started to get sick. First, he started to show agitation. And we thought maybe it was a splint bothering him because we changed it the day before. So we changed it again. But that evening, he still seemed uncomfortable. The next morning, the staff came in and found him recumbent in the cage. He was dyspneic, and we were concerned maybe he'd aspirated during sedation for the splint change. But he deteriorated during the day. Our differential diagnosis include aspiration pneumonia, transient hypoxia from the sedation, perhaps distemper, he was a young puppy, a thromboembolic event from either the fracture or from perhaps sedation. And then we started thinking about rabies. There hadn't been a case of rabies in New Hanover County in almost 60 years. And, you know, the staff fell in love with this little dog, and we started talking about, you know, having to test him for rabies. They're like, no, don't, you can't do that. You got to save him. Well, he got progressively worse, and I called Dr. McNeil, who's New Hanover County Animal Control Services manager, and said, I think we may have we've got a neurologic case. We need to check it for rabies, and she agreed. And this all, when we talk about the timeline, you'll see it happened right before Christmas. But so we did. We reluctantly euthanized him and tested him for rabies.
Of course, he came back rabies positive. It was an early morning phone call, and that's not a good thing when it comes back that soon. So when I called up to the hospital, he didn't have too many good things to say. They were like, I hope that's not Dr. McNeil, but it sure was. And the first thing we were worried about was who was exposed. We weren't sure that we could identify everyone. So many people had come through and played with Johnny. People, what do you do with the puppy but hold him in your arms and let him lick you in the face? And we wondered how on earth this could have happened. We ended up having to do post-exposure prophylaxis on 50 people. There was even one family that had traveled down to Mexico. Again, this was over the holidays. The positive results came in on December 22nd, so that was day zero. Day three, of course, was Christmas Day, and it was a cost of over $400,000 to treat all of these people. So everyone that was exposed, of course, had to go through the rig and the five post-exposure shots.
Then we got to thinking, what would have happened had we missed the diagnosis? With 50 people going through post-exposure prophylaxis, odds are, had we not gotten this right, one or two of them might have come down with rabies.